Greetings, everyone. Welcome to YQS Lab for tutorials for 3ds Max. Today, we are going to learn how to create this parametric design and to our designs, to facades or anything. This is a very famous design. It's for skyscraper. Mainly, it controls the shade and shadow and the sun. It depends on the sun location and movement. Some of these shades open and the other close and so on. So to start to know how to have this method of closing some of the shapes and opening the others, we are going to start on the 3ds Max to present this method. This is the application, quick application for the tower, and this is for the facade. Once you move the object, it reflects on the tower, as you can see here. So to start the process, we need to go for shapes and go to create this specific shape that has six sides. And once we do that, we do edit poly, and we go to polygon and select the shape. And then we do inset, give it any value. Then we scroll down to get to collapse. Once we get the collapse, we need to understand the next thing that I'm gonna say. So I have to select three vertex sides, but don't change anything. Don't change the movement, locations, anything. Just keep it this way. And then go to the edge and choose the opposite edges like this, and also don't change anything. So what you're going to do now is we are going to copy this facade. So to do this, I have to open the snap tool and right click, make sure that it's an endpoint, and then I'm going to copy this. Copy and give it maybe 25 or 28 time. So the next thing is I'm going to copy this and maybe delete this one here if I have something there. Okay, so next step now, I'm going to copy this to create the whole facade, and maybe 8 times to have it this way, to make it more symmetrical. You can copy that one here this way. Okay, so next thing is I'm going to click this object and I'm going to attach all of these shapes. So now I'm going to select one of these and go to attach. I'm going to click attach list and attach everything. But I'm not going to attach the previous facades that I created. I'm going to only attach these. And of course, I'm not going to attach the sphere. So just attach these. All right, so to make sure that it is. Okay, so next step is to go to vertex. And it's already selected what I already selected before. And what I'm going to do now is to move it in the Z-axis. So once I move it in the Z-axis, I have the start form, which represent the shades that is closed. Next step is going to be morph. So when I select morpher, now I have to select this status, which is represent the closed one. So what I'm going to do is capture current state, and I'm going to name it start. So this is the start face, and then I'm going to go back to the edit pulley and I'm going to select age. So when I select age, it has all of the selections for the ages that I had before. So what I'm going to do is scale, and I'm going to scale it this way because this is going to represent the open one. And then I'm going to change the direction to match the other one, the previous one. So once I do this, I go back to Morpher and go to this second state, and I capture this current state and status and name it open shades. Once I do this, now I need to apply the object that is going to open this facade, like that one here. Once I move it, it open and close the facade. So when I go to this facade, now I'm going to do volume select. When I have volume select, I'm going to have select the parameters vertex and invert, and I need the volume. So the volume can be anything. You can do box or maybe sphere. So now I need to go back to this and select the object to be this box. But when I change the movement and the position for this box, it doesn't change anything here. So when I need to go back here and take this volume select and have it under the morpher and make sure that the start is 100%. When I do this now, so I need to make sure that this work, but it doesn't. So what I need to go to this facade and go to volume select and make sure that I have this volume to mesh object. So once I do this, now you can see the shape start to change like this. So next step gonna be to apply this on the facade, that I'm gonna copy that one here, but it's gonna be as a reference. Once I do this as a reference, and let's say we are going to name this as a tower. Now we have this here, and when you have this as a reference, you can notice that you have a blue border here. So every modifier you're gonna have here, that it's on top of this line or the border, it's not going to affect this one. However, still applicable to change on it. If you want to change this here, and so on. All right, so let's have it this way here. Okay, so the next step now is, like, for example, edit poly. If I would like to delete, let's move this to be able to edit poly on the right face. So I'm going to delete this one here. I'm going to delete that one here to have it symmetrical. And once I do this, I can do bend. First of all, I need to rotate this one here to be a 90 degree. And once I do this, I can do bend. And I can create the tower application. Let's do 360. And if it's not tied in, let's do 370 or maybe 365. Let's do 370. And once we do this now, next step is going to be just taking this box that has the effect on it. And as you can see, this is being changing. But if I move this box into this tower, it's not going to change. It has to be on the original form. And once I do this, I'm going to take this camera, have it here. And now you can have this type of shapes or forms being applied to your facade. And this is how you are going to have this type of parametric design. And if you have any question, or maybe you would like me to do any new designs or techniques or tutorials, just write in the comments the name of the building and I will try my best. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope you learned something new today.